I've been using Windows 11 as my main operating system for about a month now, and I've been using my unattended WinStall version of Windows 11. And although I find it much better to use Windows 11 without all of the bloatware and unnecessary stuff running in the background, there are still some things I don't like about Windows 11, and that is the Taskbar, Start menu, and Right-click menu. Now the good news is there are a lot of programs that you can use to replace the shell in Windows 11, and that's what the next few videos are going to be about on my channel. If you want to check out the other videos, go ahead and look at the description of this video, and I'll have all of those videos linked in a playlist that you can go ahead and watch. In this video, I'm going to be showing you a paid software that you can use, which I think is overall the best shell replacement that you can get for Windows 11. And although it is a paid app, it's not expensive at all, and I'm going to be taking you through an entire walkthrough in this video. So the program I'm referring to is called StartAllBack, and it's what I use on both of my computers that's running Windows 11 since I've switched to Windows 11, because I just couldn't use the stock Windows 11 taskbar and start menu. So let's start by downloading StartAllBack, and you can get it from this webpage, and then just click on download, and then you can click on open file so you can run the setup. And then you'll have to go through the setup wizard. So you can either install it for the current user that you're logged into, or you can install it for all users on the computer. I'm just going to install it for all of the users on the computer and then accept this user account control prompt. And then you'll have to go through the StartAllBack configuration. So let's go through each of these. If we select proper 11, which is the default, you'll have this rounded start menu here. And if you click on these flyouts here in the system tray, you're going to have the Windows 11 menus. Also, if you open the File Explorer, you'll still have the Windows 11 command ribbon up here. If you select kinda 10, then it changes the taskbar to the Windows 10 version. And then again, if you click on these flyouts here, it's going to open the Windows 10 menus for some of these items here. You can see the notifications didn't change, but the others have changed. And then if we click on the start button, we have a classic start menu, but with sharp edges. It's not rounded like the proper 11 version is. And then if we use the remastered 7, you can see that you have the Windows 7 start button with a start menu that resembles the look of Windows 7. And then if you click on these flyouts here, you'll have the Windows 7 flyouts for these items here in the system tray. Now, the way I have it set up on my computer is to use the proper 11 version, but then to go and set some of these settings manually to my preference that I like to use. First off, you can go to the start menu tab here, and then you can choose if you want to use this classic start menu. So if I switch that off, you'll see it's going to open the Windows 11 start menu. I don't like this start menu at all, so I'll use the classic start menu. And this is basically the classic shell or open shell start menu, but the StartAllBack developer, he made his own themes and changes to these start menus here. So you can change the visual style to the default. You can change it to plain 8. Which is that menu, or to Windows 7, which is the other one I showed you earlier. I'll just leave that on the default. And then you can change the icon size to small icons, medium icons, or large icons. I changed this to small icons. Then for the all programs list, you can use large icons. You can display it as a flyout menu like in Windows XP. So if you click on all programs, it's going to open this menu here. If you deselect that checkbox there, then it's going to open the all programs list there. I like to have it set that way. And then for the rest of these settings here, you can see all of the stuff that you can change, but I normally just leave these settings on the default, but I just want to show you this so you can see all of the options that you have control over and how you can change the start menu and customize it so you can build a start menu that you like. Now, if we go to taskbar, this is probably the main reason why I like using StartAllBack, because the free programs that I've had a look at on this channel in the past few videos didn't give me exactly what I wanted with regards to the taskbar. So what I like to do is to have it as small as possible, like that. And I also set the icon margins to the smallest as possible. Now, I know this might not be for everyone, but I'm showing you what I normally do. Then you have the option of changing the start button icon. I like the normal Windows 11 icon, so I leave that selected. So one of the reasons I like StartAllBack is to make the taskbar small. The second thing is you can change the location of the taskbar, which I like to have at the top. And the reason I like to have it at the top is because most of the time In Windows, we spend time in the browser and we're navigating tabs here at the top of the screen. So it's just much easier to navigate to the top of the screen here and get to icons and the start menu that I want to access, as well as the system tray icons here, compared to having the taskbar at the bottom of the screen and then moving the mouse all across the screen. That's just my personal preference, and you can leave a comment down below telling me how wrong I am and how bad that actually is. I don't care. That's the way I like to use my computer, and you can use your computer the way that you like. Now, another thing that I like with regards to the taskbar styling here is to turn on dynamic transparency, and that makes the entire taskbar completely transparent. Now, you also have some other options here, like combining the taskbar buttons. You can always combine them and hide the labels as well, only when the taskbar is full or never. And if you set it to never, then you'll have these labels on the taskbar icons. I always hide the labels. I don't like to have it centered in the screen here, so I leave that off as well. And then you have the option of segmenting these taskbars here. I don't like that either, so I just leave that turned off as well. Now, if we have a look at the tray icons here, which are the system tray icons here, you can choose the flyout style. So you can have the Windows 11 flyouts, or the Windows 10 flyouts, or the Windows 7 flyouts where it's possible. I like to have the Windows 10 flyouts selected, where I have this soundbar and that network icon there. But you also have the option of changing this to Windows 7, and it'll use the Windows 7 flyouts for these icons where it's possible. I'm going to leave that on Windows 10, but now you have some more options here where you can turn the system icons on or off. So first off, for the taskbar, if you wanted to enable the search icon, if I click on that icon there and I enable the search box, you'll see that I have the search icon here. I always have that hidden, but I just wanted to show you that you can change that here. It's the same with the task view button, and it's also the same with the widgets. I don't use any of that, so I just leave that unselected. And then you have some other options here. So for example, you've got the language switcher. If I click on that and set it to off, you can see that the language switcher has now disappeared. And it's the same if I go ahead and disable the action center or the notification pane, then the notification icon is also hidden. Now you can do that with all of these other options here as well. If you wanted to hide these icons here, you can turn off the other system tray icons and you won't see those as well. But I just leave that set to on. And if you want, you can just select this setting here, which will always show all of the app icons without hiding it with this arrow here. So I'm going to leave that selected. Then if we go over to the Explorer section, you can use the Windows 11 command bar, the Windows 10 ribbon, or the Windows 7 command bar. Now that is the File Explorer here. So if I set this to the Windows 10 ribbon UI and we reopen it, you'll see that is the Windows 10 ribbon, which is what I like using. But you can also use the Windows 7 command bar, which is just this file edit view and tools option here. So I like to have this set to Windows 10. Then you can have this mica effect on top. You can use the classic search box, new icons, and the new icons is basically what's added with Start AllBack. If I disable that and then open the File Explorer again, this is like the classic Windows 10 icons. But I think the new icons look pretty good, so I always leave that enabled. Now you can use the classic context menus, which is referring to this right-click menu here. You can restore the control panel applets, which is basically if you go to control panel and you, for example, choose system, it's going to take you to the old system page and it won't redirect you to the Windows 11 settings. Then you have this option to colorize everything with the accent color in Windows, which is what I like to have selected as well. Now you might see that although the taskbar is transparent, as soon as I click on the start button, it uses the accent color of the light theme of Windows. So if I go and I enable the dark theme in Windows, I change this to dark, then you can see it's transparent until I click on the start menu, and then it changes it to the accent color or the background color that I have selected here. If we go to the advanced section, if you wanted to, you can also use a custom start menu color and custom taskbar color. And if you select these options, you can also choose between clear, blur, and acrylic. So one of the things you can do here is to select both of these items and then change this setting to clear, for example, which will basically give you this see-through type of start menu here. For this video, I'm just going to deselect that and then use the previous version that I had here. Then you also have some other settings here where you can store and display recently opened programs and display recently opened items, which are the settings in the start menu here. Now, if you go to the About page here, this is where you can enter a license key. And as you can see, you get 100 days where you can use StartAllBack for free. So 100 days is plenty of time for you to test out this program and see if it'll work for you. Like I said, I've been using it for a month now and I haven't had any issues with it yet. So if you want to use StartAllBack as a shell replacement on Windows 11, you can go ahead and you can try it out for yourself. And if you're wondering how to get back to the StartAllBack settings, you can right click on the taskbar and then select properties, which will take you back to this configuration, or you can go to the control panel and then you'll have this StartAllBack entry here that you can select, and then you can also get back to the settings that way. I really recommend trying out StartAllBack and giving it a shot to see if it'll work for you. And I use StartAllBack in conjunction with Shell, which basically gives you this right-click menu. And I've made a separate video about Shell on my channel, which you can go and have a look at. And you can also check out the other videos that's part of this series, where I show you a bunch of different programs that you can use to tweak the taskbar, the start menu, the file explorer, and the right-click menu in Windows 11. But I really hope you found some sort of value in this video. If you did, please give it a like. And if you'd like to support me and this channel, you can check out my YouTube member section. But with that being said, thanks so much for watching. I'll talk to you guys soon.